out, you'll see only one we see off the bike right now.
Okay.
Gotcha.
station. Okay. Chance of rain until 2. Stick.
100% of our ride is going 2.40%.
Yikes.
My brain's going like, you know, if we would have canceled the ride, we wouldn't have rained up here all day. Right. We would have thunderstorm lightning back home. Right. All day.
Well, like I said last night, I would have been on the trainer. I'd rather test this than sit on the trainer for 3.5. Oh well, we'll get wet, it'll dry out. Good. obviously it's not going to all be downhill on the way back. Okay. But I think Brian said we'll stop at the Y, the connector. Yeah. So based on my current weight and knowing how I felt at Ortishore, my guess is I lost 10 pounds the week of Ortishore. Yeah, if you ride it more often, you get used to it. No. Kevin, I was really hoping you were going to do a valley spur up in Munising. Oh, you did?
Yeah.
I missed it. What'd you think? Yeah. I really like that back half. Yeah.
Yeah,
yeah. And you come around a corner and all of a sudden you're on a big ravine like this.
Yeah.
Yep. Coming back. I knew when we start. What's that? When we started going down first, right when we got in the trail, I'm like, oh boy, I think we're in trouble. If you want to ride up ahead with those guys, I'm gonna ride with Brian. I don't think I'm gonna push it that hard and kind of stick.
I'm not gonna have any more than that on the hills, but I might roll the downhills faster.
Downhill back there is gonna be.
Oh, it'll be all dry. 85% humidity.
Oh, I did rip my shorts in there.
How are you doing back there?
I'm okay.
Yeah,
it's just like having that much time off.
Yeah.
It sucks.
I like a good 2 hour warm up and then 20 minute cool down.
I know. What's harder, out or back?
Out. It's about an hour and 15 on the way back of a 3.5 hour ride. Typically. Unless you're completely gassed during the time.
That's a 4 hour ride.
Or you just turn around it.
Which is always an option. It just gets better from here on out.
Yeah, we're tall.
He went back down the hill.
He's gonna do it again?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, he's gonna go collect Tim.
Oh, I thought he was with us.
I think my heart rate got up to like 190.
Well, at least you're well rested.
Yeah. Oh man. Heart rate zone 5.6.
Is it typical for the hill repeat intervals to be able to do the first couple well and then like have zero energy for call it 4 and 5? And then
of your muscle type,
take that 5 minute break and then 6 through 10. 6 is probably another weak one, but then 7 through 10 is probably almost as strong as 1 through 3.
Yeah. Well, that's why you're taking a 5-minute break.
Mm-hmm.
Your body's learning how to reload itself and get the fast-twitch muscle more energy reserves again so it can do that again.
And it seems to work better the second time.
Yeah, because your body's going, oh, nice.
I always feel like it takes me like 25 minutes to really, truly warm up. And that's all I can, it's like a switch. I can feel it. But that's always been the case. So I don't know if those drills help.
Yeah.
quicken that, if there's anything to do to quicken that.
No, it might more be...
Get younger?
It might be upstairs as well, too. A lot of times people are thinking that they're not warmed up and they're beating the crap out of the bike themselves and everybody else is out there looking at them going, holy crap.
Could be. You ready to go up the hill? Tight, wet spaces, but that was a little sketchy back there. Thank you. 38 degrees. Yeah, we're 88. You looking to drop back, Mark?
Yep.
Okay.
Stay left!
One way to break it in.
I had no choice. I broke it out at the game area. I sat in my garage for a month. I finally thought, well, I suppose I better get in there and get a training.
You should have taken your fat bike.
Huh?
Should have taken your fat bike.
I have to have Brian take a look at that before I ride it probably next time.
Follow my voice!
Oh, one of the, at Owasapi, like the one of the climbs, and there's a fast grassy downhill. There's a stump like off to the left.
Oh,
and
yeah.
Caught the edge of it and chipped part of the rim.
Oh,
I rode two more loops out there.
What's that?
It's held
right
air.
Now.
I was nervous.
But if we keep having the way like this, we're gonna touch the loops. I don't mean to be like that.
Oh, I'm sorry, dude.
You keep pushing the pace like this.
I'll try to go faster.
Tim's brother.
Thanks, Don.
For a second, I thought
you pooped. Like the tweaking knee a little bit.
I think this is the first time I was on this trail.
It's a nice
bringing
view.
Up the back too. It's very, if you've never done it before and you don't realize the climbing that you're going to do, you're not mentally prepared for it.
So far.
Plus the downhill's being wet.
Yep.
You all right, Leslie?
I tweaked my knee.
Throw it away. Don't get rid of your knee. a little problem, but.
That one right there.
That
yeah.
one with the tape on it?
Yeah.
No, the other one. It looks good.
All right. Dumbest question of the day. I win that one.
The one with the bullseye on it?
Did you go down again, or is that just from before? You got the side of your arm.
No, this is from before.
Right here. Your arm right here.
Yeah, that's why I decided I'm just gonna.
Damn, I'm glad I'm
first. Fell like 30 feet.
Is this from today?
Yeah.
I was on your ass.
I was saying, yeah.
You got a long way to go before you land. You're like,
Now I know who to stay behind.
You see me?
Yeah, don't. He's like, crash.
I fell down
here.
I didn't realize it was a
me.
It's like losing your rear wheel coming out.
No,
on
no, that's fine.
So is there a river
down these downhills? It's a little slick out
that
there,
way.
Dude.
Don't worry, you won't hit the river.
Back
about
to the 200 ER
yards that way, if you're lucky.
Thank you.
riding on a Tuesday, Thursday, or Saturday to do Lord of the Springs, right? I bet you could ride this, Mark.
I might. Really, I'm
stuck. I think you'd just duck a little bit. It'll be fine. Meaning it's feasible or it's allowed?
It's both.
Okay.
It's probably really hard today.
It wasn't long ago he told me 700.
What's that?
Elevation. Climbing.
It's been fun climbing though.
Yeah. Well, we're not killing it, so it's like not.
Matt Morocco.
Hey, Tim, you didn't happen to bring your Bluetooth speaker, did you?
That would be kind of cool, actually.
Oh, I forgot. Sorry. Didn't want to disrupt nature.
Listening to Mark's hub reminded me of that whole conversation.
There's pretty much self-explanatory.
Okay.
From here on out.
Did we already do the?
Yeah.
Was that that area back there?
Yeah.
Kind of,
we were all together, so yeah. Everybody just scooted right through it. And right now it's really well defined. When you come through here sometimes you come through here and you don't actually see this.
Yeah.
So you come through here and it's just like there's just open trees everywhere. And you can't see the trail, so this is another place where people see that. They go up that way, and then they
see this wood, the leaves falling.
Uh-huh. Yeah, early spring, and in the fall, it's like if you don't know the trail, you get to this point. Even I know the trail, I get up to this point, and I'm doing one of these for it.
I'll never forget. We rode Glacial Hills after Iceman out one time. I was like, where the hell do we go? Like, you literally couldn't see the trail.
The leaves were that deep.
We're going to keep rolling. If you guys never don't want to.
But the one thing Ryan said is plan on going, if you're going to turn around, not get all the way up.
Yeah.
Go a little further than halfway.
Yeah, it's a 2-to-1 ratio. 2 hours that way, 1 hour that way.
Really?
Yeah.
It just seems like we've been going downhill a lot more.
I think he's serious.
I think that's
you would be right on your back wheel.
I think that's the comment of the day.
I was like, wait a minute, Brian said it's easier on the way.
No, I feel like we've been going downhill, but
it's just long. I mean, not like steeps, but
steeps and goats.
Good to know. I was gonna cut a 1:30 because I figured it was gonna take me 2 hours to get back.
Well, let me just put it to you this way. We got probably another 1,000 feet of climbing yet to go on this layout. So.
You don't have to tell me that.
We got almost 1,000 down already.
Thank you. Hey, while I have most of you guys here, I think I got all you guys. Just real quick, I want to say I do appreciate that you guys waited for us. I know you guys would,
you
but...
You guys figured it out? Yeah. Okay. Whose is it? Whose is bigger?
No, that's not what I meant. I'm not waiting. I meant waiting in the parking lot. I'm not talking about you guys waiting up here for us. I'm telling all you guys, I'm thankful you guys waited for us in the parking lot. There's a riot.
What is it, Mark? You always say playing bikes.
Playing bikes. What, playing bikes? We're playing bikes in the rain today, Garrett.
Yep.
we're boys. We like to get muddy.
Yeah. It's
I don't like getting wet.
Where do you get better?
It's safe, Dad.
No, it's not.
Did you hear me say earlier I normally like tight, wet spots, but some of this...
Just thought of that. Well, we get to go down this one. Stopping? Thank you. Enjoy your ride. Roots. got Dunn and Jarrett behind me. We draft Eddie and Kevin. Turn around really just up ahead?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I was gonna say, we took off without Kevin.